Hello everyone. So it's day 40 here, 100% raw vegan, two meals a day. And I've been going up and down again. So waking up in the morning, feeling very lethargic, wanting to sleep in, but getting up, you know, because we do our work here on at the academy in the morning. So we're building a pavilion at the moment, which is going to be new accommodation. Some new accommodation quarters. And so getting up, getting moving, getting into it. And so I'm feeling very lethargic, like I just want to sleep, just feeling very slow, lacking energy. So John says that that is the energy of the body, the vital force of the body going inwards and using its energy for regeneration. So some people might say, well, you're not getting enough of certain things, certain nutrients, certain calories. John says, no, you are getting enough, but it's just the vital force moving inwards in order to do its regeneration. So it's a journey of investigation. It's an exploration. We'll see how this goes. A couple of things to note is that, well, John doesn't suffer from it. So John gets up and he has enough energy. He's a smaller man than I am, but he reckons that the amount of food consumed, regardless of how big you are, shouldn't really vary much, especially once your body weight, body size, body mass has been established. So he's saying that, you know, you'll have periods where you have seemingly more energy and periods where you have less energy, depending on what the vital force is doing. So in this particular instance, I'm feeling a bit low. And one thing I have noticed is that some days I'll have more energy and then I'll go through periods where I have less energy and all of a sudden I'm feeling good again. So I'm getting about 10 hours sleep for the last 3 nights in a row, and I've definitely needed it. Normally I'd get up and I'd do I do a meditation practice, a Kriya Yoga meditation practice, which involves basic stretching and meditation. But I even haven't had the energy to be able to do that in the morning. But I get up and I go to work. And one thing I have noticed, you know, like I have been shoveling some rock dust and doing things like that and moving some stuff around. And that activity actually improves the lethargy. So I actually start to feel a whole lot better. Getting that move, that muscle movement going. And that's one thing John says, is that rather than lying in bed, because overnight you'll have the body going into a mode of detoxification, regeneration, and toxins will build up in the bloodstream and in the blood plasma and in the lymph. And these toxins will have effects. So they'll make you feel lethargic, but they'll also irritate the nerves. They'll have these different effects. And rather than let that sit, you know, to get up and be active, you know, to do some type of activity, and just working on the farm is enough. You don't have to go for a run, but working on the farm is enough, according to John's lifestyle theory and practice. And certainly that proved true for me. Getting up and doing some work, shoveling some rock dust and all that type of stuff, it made me feel a whole lot better. Because the only way that that lymph is going to get moving is through muscular action. So the squeezing of the muscles helps pump the lymph through and also encourage venous return, so the body's able to distribute those toxins to the organs of elimination and pass them out. So that's something interesting. Don't lay in bed if you can. Get up, do some work. If you're still feeling tired, then you probably have to go back to bed. But normally what I'd do is I'd sleep in the afternoon if I needed to, after the evening meal. Sorry, after the lunch meal, the midday meal. I might go and have a nap. So day 40, one thing I did a few days ago was a bit naughty. We went out and we visited a friend, and this friend of mine makes the best chocolate that I know of anyone. It's a very pure, raw, unrefined chocolate. All he puts in is a bit of rapadura, which is organic, unrefined coconut sugar as a sweetener. And definitely the best chocolate I've ever tasted. But chocolate is a stimulant, and I'm going to do a video on stimulants right after this. So it'd be good if you could watch that. But being a stimulant and also creating a measure of acidity in the body and the breakdown products of the caffeine causing other problems, I felt very lethargic. It was only a few squares, but I felt very lethargic for a few days after, and also suffered from a low-grade headache, that being the detox from the acid products from those stimulants. So he doesn't put any other additives in his chocolate. There's no processed sugars, no dairy or anything like that. So a very pure form of chocolate, and even that I found affected my mind, affected my brain, affected my energy levels. So it's interesting to wonder, you know, if you have that stuff regularly, what it might do. So we eat these things for supposed health benefits, but you know, what health benefits are there really, and is it really good for us? Sure, we can feel good temporarily, and you know, it has these effects on the nervous system, but you know, how necessary is it? How good is it? How good is it long term, and what quantities? So I actually regret, even though it tasted good and I enjoyed the taste of it, I didn't really enjoy the effects of it, especially longer term. Short term stimulation, longer term suffering and the effects of it. It took me a few days to recover, and the fact that I had those low grade headaches through detox. So, you know. So going up and down a bit, I would like to be eating some more calories in the form of fruit sugar, but again, I'm under John's regime, and I'm also going to share more about our diet in the coming videos. So that's all for now. Stay tuned. Thanks for watching, and remember to have fun. See you again soon. Bye-bye.